Hello, welcome to week 13 of the 40-week series to support the parents of toddlers through the second year of their cochlear implant who have received cochlear implant at a very early age, before the age of 2 years. If you wish to download the full resource from our website, please click the link given below. Subscribe to Cochlear India YouTube channel and press the icon of bell so that you get the notification for the next episode. So today we will talk about goals and objectives and activities for week 13, starting with auditory goals. We expect your child to self-monitor now automatically. So you should expect from your child to come and tell you if the batteries are weak or the sound is not coming properly and the child cannot hear properly. The child should also be able to self-monitor the speech and make automatic corrections. For example, if you tell the child to say Baba, but the child says Papa, you don't repeat the input and you ask the child, what did you hear? The child should be able to self-correct and say Baba. Coming to receptive language goals, we expect that your child should be able to understand the descriptions and give you the name of the object. So for descriptions, for example, I can give you the example of a ball. You say that it's a toy, it's round, it can bounce. We play with it in the playground and the child should be able to say ball. You can pick up something from the transport. For example, if you say it's a vehicle, we travel by it. It goes on the road, it has 3 wheels and it makes a lot of noise. The child should be able to say auto rickshaw. For example, you pick up some animal and you say it's an animal. It stays in the forest, eats other animals. It runs very fast and it has stripes on its body. So the child should be able to say tiger. Coming to your second goal of receptive language, the child should understand now when you say what can dash. For example, suppose you ask what can you make, or you give the lot of markers and paper and ask what can you draw, or you can say give Lego blocks or blocks and say what can you make, what can you do. So these questions the child should be able to understand and answer. Another question you expect your child to understand this week is what with the verb. For example, if you ask what sinks, what floats, what flies, what makes noise, so the child should be able to think of an object. Initially, you can keep some toys and ask about, take the object from those toys. He has to pick up a toy after hearing the description, or pictures on A4 sheet chart. There are different pictures and you talk about one, or you can just now later on go to open-ended questions. You just say and the child listens and gives you the answer. In expressive language, we also expect your child to be able to add more 3-4 word sentences. For example, expect your child to say, it's yummy, I will win, you will lose, I can't find my shoes, all these new sentences which he was not using earlier. In speech goals, we are still working on ber, de, and ge. Earlier, we were on babbling, then on words, and now we are moving to sentences. So use sentence which uses two or three of these three different sounds. For example, suppose you tell your child, go and get the ball. So you're using go and b. Suppose you tell your child, let's give Dolly a bath. Then you're doing b, d, and g. All three sounds in one sentence. Coming to speech goals, again, there is another goal we are working on this week. We start with auditory bombardment of t. So suppose you take the category of vegetables and then you use the words tomato, potato, carrot, where t is at a different place in different words. You can take the category of animals and in that you can talk about turtle, tiger, cat. Otherwise, in daily routine, tea, butter, table, so many words you can use meaningfully whenever you are playing with the child, talking to the child, or telling a story. So, tips. The first tip for this week is start playing a lot of pretend play. We are moving away from real objects now to three-dimensional objects, which represent closely the real objects. So keep a lot of toys and these things on the table and the child will play with them and use them as real toys and real objects. For example, suppose you say that you are going to celebrate the doll's birthday. There is clay on the table. So the child picks up the clay, pats it and rounds it and makes it as cake. And then the child picks up the toothpicks and puts on the clay and says that these are candles. Again, if you say, okay, let's cut the cake, the child might pick up ice cream stick and say it's a knife and cuts the cake. And you all sing, happy birthday, dear Dolly. So this children, they love to play Dolly's birthday. They love to play Mama, Papa. They love to play Doctor, Doctor. Lot of pretend plays they would love. So start doing this week. The next tip, model spoken language. Your child might have lot of ideas, thoughts, needs, which cannot be expressed because of lack of language. So what you do is give the correct sentence for the particular gesture the child is using to increase the vocabulary and language of the child. For speech errors, you still expect some of the speech errors within the same domain of consonant manner. For example, if the child is confusing m and n, sh and f, b and b, that's all right. This is a developmental speech error, but give auditory closure, give auditory bombardment, give repetition and tell the child to imitate. If he gets it, fine. If he doesn't get it, it's okay. There is a support material. Where is that? I kept it here. If you have downloaded the resource from the website, at the end of the resource, there is a support material. One of the support material is West by Symbolic Play Scale. In this, if you see, if your child is 2 years old, then what is expected from your child is that he should be using plurals and use S in the end, tables, chairs, books. And the child should be able to use apostrophe S for possessives, such as mamas, papas, and play, pretend play. So according to the age of your child, you can go through this and you can see what you should expect from your child and what games you can play with your child. Book for this week, Where is My Daddy? So this book is selected for this week, Where is My Daddy? A very simple book, but it has two advantages. There is minimal pairs in this book, which helps the child to do speech discrimination and understand the difference of sounds. It also has new vocabulary, taking the child from known to unknown, from simple to complex, higher vocabulary. For example, this is the book of a bear. He's a teddy bear. There's a boy. The boy's name is Eddie, and Eddie lost his teddy. The teddy's name was Freddy. So did you hear? Eddie, Teddy, Freddy. So when the child imitates, the child has to listen and understand the discrimination of these sounds. So then what happens, I'm not telling every page, just to let you know. The child goes and looks for his teddy, which he has lost, but he saw a huge bear. So he lost a little teddy and he found a huge teddy. So see the difference? And then he saw a gigantic bear coming up, like a giant, big, huge bear, who was holding the little teddy. So all this, and then what you see in the next is, the huge bear throws the little teddy bear down and takes his big teddy, his huge teddy. And in the end, you can talk about which is huge, which is big, which is little, small, they can compare. And visually, it is very clear what is the difference in little and huge and gigantic. So this helps to develop new vocabulary through every book. You must have guessed, the theme for this week is toys. Well, if you have any questions, write in the comments and I will answer them. See you next week.